Hey there, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've been here before. Today I'm going to be showing you how to set up a forwarding email for email to case within Salesforce. If you're looking for the whole email to case process from start to end, then I do have a video for that and I'll link it down below. But if you're just here for email forwarding, I will get right into it. So, I have two different emails open and I have my Salesforce org open. I do recommend having two different emails. One, you're going to want that email that you will be forwarding from there. So I do have that. This is the new SF user course. This is just a burner email that I use. And so I want to use this to forward into our Salesforce org. I also have another email, this one, which is call certification course. That is going to be the one that I'll be sending my test emails from. So let's go ahead and go back into our org, and I'm going to go to service setup. I have set this up for a few different orgs, so it'll show that here. Email, not Emily. Email to case. And I'm going to click continue. So here it says all my case settings have been set up how I like it. And I'm going to add a new routing address. I've already set up one, but that's all right. Then you choose the routing name. So this could be the name of, let's say, possibly the record type that you're going to be using, or possibly you have different routing for different departments. So let's say you have an executive suite and they have a different routing email address than everyone else at the company, just so they can receive a better, faster service. Then you'd want to put this in the routing name, as well as maybe you have an internal case team for email to case and an external case team for email to case, where you can have customers as well as employees email, and then those two email to cases won't get muddled and mixed. So I'm just going to have this be the name of the email that I'm going to use, just to make it a little easier on me. This could be support@companyname.com, or it could be customer support or customer success, whatever it be. Or you could have this, the routing name for your internal, be external case support. I'm going to enter in the email address. I'm going to accept email headers, double check that email is correct, create a task from email, and then we can choose the task status. I'm going to keep it at not started. You need to enter in a case owner. Just going to enter myself. Case priority, you can have this automatically mapped to high, medium, low. Of course, you can change it later depending on your visibility and if you can edit it. And then I'm going to go click case origin. This is always so funny to me because it's obviously email, because it's email to case, but it provides you web and phone. So I'm going to click save here. And okay, just telling us that it's going to send an email off. And now we wait for that email, and it looks like it just came through. And we have to verify now. And I'm going to verify by clicking that link. Okay. And it'll take us to home. I'm going to exit out of that, go back to the home screen, and back here. So this is not going to work. If we email newsfusercourse@gmail.com, it's not going to open up a new case, because we now have to set up forwarding in our email manager. So we use Gmail for our email manager. If you use Outlook, the process will be fairly similar, just possibly in a different spot. Let's go ahead. I'm going to copy this email address, or this forwarding domain. Copy it, and now we're going to go into Gmail and see all settings. Go to forwarding and add a forwarding address. Now, this is where you're going to want to add this forwarding domain. It's going to be the email name at case.salesforce.com with a bunch of unique characters. And click next. Proceed. All right, and it has been added. Now we need to go into our cases and get a confirmation code for Gmail. So then they know this is actually going where it's supposed to be going. So I'm on the homepage of our Salesforce org in the service app. Go to cases. I'm going to go to all open cases. I want to make sure that it's today because I've set a few of these up. And this is the correct one. In the details or the description of the case, we can find the confirmation code. Copying that over to paste in our email. Click verify. And as a default, it's always on disable forwarding. So you're going to want to click forwarding that email. And you can choose the settings on how you want this email address to keep the copies that are not being forwarded. I like to have just a digital footprint. So in case, let's say the org gets disabled, we are still able to help our customers, but it'll just mark it as red. So then you don't have an inbox of 10,000. And from here, go to save changes. All right, and now it is all set up. So let's go ahead and send a test email. I'm going to send it to new SF user course, gmail.com. Test from call course. And I'm going to send it off. So I will see this show up hopefully here in this inbox fairly soon because it is working pretty quickly today. And then we'll also check it in our open cases. Here we go. We see the test from call course. Let's go back to our open cases. And test from call course is here at the bottom. Let's go ahead and open that up. And that is how you do email forwarding within email to case. I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down below. I'll get back to you as fast as I can. Like, subscribe, do all that fun stuff. I do have some courses on Salesforce certifications and training. If you are interested, I will leave them down below. So I'll catch you guys in the next one.